wisely, then you going to manifest what you're contaminated with. Mighty men shall fall from the faith because their well get contaminated. Contaminated with pride. Contaminated with maliciousness. Contaminated with sexual immorality. Contaminated with the spirit of lies. Hallelujah. Because we have a lot of false prophets out there now. They listen people situation and come back and prophesy it. Preach the name of the Lord. And we have people prophesying out of their emotion. So we have to have the well that is in us. And the well will allow us to discern the good and the bad things. Because we're living in a time and a day where the word of the Lord said fire gonna fall from heaven. And the devil gonna convince you that is God. But he said if you hear that he's over there not on the housetop, it is not God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. He said, I will be coming back from the east. He said, saw the lightning flash from the east unto the west. So the coming of the men shall be. Praise God with me, no man. We have to understand and read and study to show ourselves approved, because we're going to have fortune tellers will come. Oh God Almighty, the palm readers will come. Hallelujah. The person that really the hypnotizing spirit will come. Hallelujah. And they will come and tell you all type of things in your life, but you must have the well on your inside. Church. So this fountain in hearts never run dry. Cannot. The only time it stop flow is when sin come in. Because Jesus said he condemned sin in the flesh. And when Jesus condemned sin in the flesh, don't tell me you sin because it come over you. No. You sin because you want to sin. Because God already condemned sin in the flesh and give you power over the flesh. Hallelujah. He said, behold, I give you power to tread upon serpents and upon scorpions and everything. Hallelujah. So when we want to do something, because we want to do it. Amen. Amen. So we want to know if we're carrying the right well, because some of our well gets stale. Hallelujah. Some of us are wells, but we have nothing to flow into people's life. We don't want to be stagnant. No time for stagnancy. No time to take on some things that is not ours. We need to take on what God has for us, that we can flow as a spring. Hallelujah. In our life, spring up into everlasting life. So when you begin to spring into everlasting life, that mean you are moving in the line that God predestinates your life to be. Amen. Yes, Jacob well is good and is important, but Jesus said, the woman said, then there is a greater well than Jacob well. That's what she knows. She speak of what she know. But here come a greater one. She said, give me to drink. Just give me this water you're talking about, that I don't come back here to draw no more. That tells me probably she tired to come at the well. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You ever sick and tired of one situation? And you said, God, 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 God. Give me to drink. I need this situation to be quenched. I need to master the situation. I need to mature over it. I need to pass this stage and this level. Because from me being saved, you cannot grow to a place where the water in you will speak to you, your hobby. The word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, help us God. Because we don't understand that. He said, when you accept him as Lord and Savior, he will come into your life. Many times we have Jesus come into our life, but we don't know how to activate him. We don't know to access him. So he stays in us and die. And then we will have to rebirth him all over again. And that is why I preached and I said the church is going through a cycle of rebirth. They don't want to birth new things in God and experience something new. Because as soon as you birth something, the devil put anxiety on you and pride on you and all type of feeling on you until what you have just birthed. And then you will have to birth it all over again. So we live in a cycle of rebirth. Hallelujah. You went and 21 day fast. You said, God, I have a neighbor. Always I give me problem. And it's hard for me to love this person. And you went and fasting for 21 days and said, God, I want you to help me to love this person. Hey, hallelujah. And when you went on the fasting, glory to God, and finished, the Lord allowed you to birth the anointing of love on your inside. And when the Lord set up the test for you to go over and to tell the person morning, you keep saying, me can't go, Jesus. You pray, God give it to you. But the self, man, this is your enemy. Always I come tell you, you can't do it. Yourself is an enemy. It always a block you. And if you don't pass that test, then you will have to go back again and bring back the love of the anointing of love to master the person that you're asking God about. Amen. How much time we feel it is? Amen. Hallelujah. How much time you feel the test? We pray for a lot of things and God give it to us, you know. But we don't do what he commands us to do. So we feel the test. And then we feel dry and empty. Hallelujah. Because when you don't follow the obedience of God, it's like witchcraft, you know. Disobedience is sin. And when you don't follow the obedience of God, it is like witchcraft. Because when you disobey him, come on now, you begin to pay the price of your disobedience. Then you say, people, I hope you. Rebellion is a sin. Glory to God. Amen, church. So we want to understand that when you pray, when you go and fasting, you must see result. After you fast, you must see something happen. You don't fast, and yet the scripture says when you go and fasting, you wash your face, you come up here, come on the man, and you look pleasant. Glory to God. It's not for you to go over and say, oh, I am fasting for 20 days. I am fasting. Come on, you're looking some attention. No. You don't have to tell nobody that you are fasting. It is a silent weapon against the devil. But you know why the devil defeats us oftentimes? Because we talk so many things and talk out the things that we're supposed to not. We're not supposed to say it, but we talk it anyhow and give the devil the information and him go black road on us. And instead of we come out being fruitful, come out being victorious, the devil black us and we have to go back again and rebirth and start all over. It is very hard, brethren. Hallelujah. So we're looking at the well. One flow and one store water. We want to store water, but at the same time, we must be flowing. Amen. Amen. That when you come to me, what I have will flow to your heart. Amen, church. We teach on the anointing, that the anointing, it flows into a person's life. It is still the well. It is still the river. Amen. So if you're not carrying the river of God on your inside, then you cannot flow. Some people flow easily in gossiping. Some people flow easily in mix-up, hallelujah, and to tear down people. But when it come on to flow in the righteous part by encouraging people and pray for persons, we fear to do that part. Because the word of the Lord said we're born in sin. and shaping iniquity. Hallelujah. So when I want to do good, evil present itself. But when the evil present itself, that doesn't mean the evil gonna come in. Look into the scripture. When I want to do good, evil present itself. But if the evil present itself, it is me who have to decide if I want to do the evil or the good. Hallelujah. But some persons, they quote the scripture and they say, when I want to do good, evil present itself, so therefore I can't do good. The devil is a liar. Don't twist it here. Evil will always present itself, but that doesn't mean you have to do the evil. Hey, no more bullshit, hey, no more Santa. Yes, actually, morality will confront you. Glory, but that doesn't mean you must perform the act of sexual immorality. Because all of us will be challenged with the devil plan and the devil devices. But that doesn't mean you have to act it out. I wonder if you're catching me today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If I'm carrying the well of God on my inside and it keeps flowing with such a powerful anointing, when evil presents itself, I'm going to discern it. And when I discern it, then it's up to me if I want to do the good or the evil.
Hallelujah.
So we use this scripture to justify our acts. When I want to do evil present itself, no, don't use it to justify sin. Come on, the man, you must say, when evil present itself, I'm still gonna do good. I'm still gonna flow. I will be focused. I will not get distracted. The spirit of evil will not take me over. When I want to talk the truth, and the devil said, tell me, I'm gonna talk the truth. Shame the devil, man. And when you tell the lie, you the one feel bad afterwards. And nobody will trust you no more and believe in you no more, because the devil bring lie in your mouth and you speak the lie for true. But you have a choice not to say it. You catching me, church? Hallelujah. Jesus walked 100% man and 100% God. And he did not sin. And if God said, be ye holy, for I am holy. Come on now. Don't tell me you can't walk in a holiness. If Jesus said it, all you need is the right persons to teach you, to pray for you, to guide you, and to instruct you for you to walk in holiness. Because sometimes when you walk as a babe, even some older Christian in churches, we lack teaching. So that is why we always tripping over and doing the wrong things. But if you have the right people in your corner, you will walk in holiness. We are our brother and sister's keeper. It's not like Cain and Abel. When you present your offering and the Lord asks his brother, where is Cain? Or where is Abel?
He
says, am I my brother's keeper? No. Hallelujah. No. It is here with us today. We're not business with you. How can we serve in the same God that you're not business with me? When the agape love come with something named care and concern and seek out your whereabouts and how you doing, how you survive, how you eat, you work, what is happening, how can I help? Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you carry the fountain, you carry the fruit of the Spirit. In Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 and 23, speak about the love of God. When you read it, it is a character, his attribute, his nature. This is what he possesses. And if we're gonna walk with this man Jesus, come on. I said it yesterday and I will say it again. Once upon a time I thought that serving God is just come to church and sit down and say, hallelujah, hallelujah. and go back home. Hallelujah. It's more than that. It's deeper than that. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost carry two things, and it's so important that we need is the principles and discipline. And when we walk in sin, we lock, most time we lock these things. If we grew up into some strict family home or parent at home, then we have a little bit of it, but not much. Praise God Almighty. But when you come into God, He will teach you discipline.